And now...
Marcia, yoo-hoo!
Oh, what is it, Kay?
Marcia, how come you prefer guys like Ishka Bibble and High Averback to me? Why is that?
Well, Kay, they're professional people. Ish knows about football, and High knows about radio.
Well, I'm a professional, too. I've been studying hard, and I'm now the world's newest type of doctor.
The newest type? Whatever do you mean?
We'll show you, Marcia, as we now present a drama of the modern medical world entitled... Medicine Marches On, or... Don't put dynamite in the patient's skull. You want to blow his top? At the Kaiser Clinic, there is tension in the air. Young Dr. Kaiser bends over his operating table.
Ready, nurse? Scalpel?
Scalpel.
Alcohol.
Alcohol.
Sponge.
Sponge.
Alcohol.
Alcohol.
Suture.
Suture.
Alcohol.
Alcohol. Doctor, there's a crowd of patients waiting outside to see you.
Ah, humanity must be served. Nurse, it makes me happy to see people suffering because I know I can help them. I'm a great doctor dedicated to the principles of medical ethics. I must see these people and alleviate their terrible suffering. But first, there's just one thing.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, Nick.
Nick? But, doctor, what if my mother should come in?
She comes in, I'll neck her, too. Who's this?
Oh, it's your first patient, doctor.
Hey, doctor, what do you know about liver trouble?
I don't know, Ace. What do you know about liver trouble?
Well, I fry the onions in glue so they won't slide off.
You're a moron. J.G.
Now, Mr. Kaiser, are you a legitimate doctor?
Legitimate? Eesh, look at all the degrees I've got up on the wall.
But, Doc, all you got up there is a thermometer.
That's right. On that one wall alone, I got 72 degrees.
Tell you, I heard you're not so good. Didn't you operate on a patient who jumped off the table before he could sew him up?
Before I could sew him up? What makes you think so?
I just seen him running around without a stitch. And they tell me you're a specialist.
Specialist? Why, right. I specialize in the treatment of diseases caused by listening to radio commercials.
That's wonderful. Professor, you're my man.
Why? What's your trouble?
Well, I can't. I've tried it, but I can't do it. I can't do it. I tell you, I can't do it.
You can't do what?
I can't pass the fingernail test.
Oh, this is terrible. You've tried running your fingers over your scalp?
Yeah.
Uh-huh, and what happened?
My fingernails drop off. Professor, what should I do?
Just a second. Let me look into my medical textbook. Ah, here we are. Page 76, Saturday Evening Post. For your scalp, we'll have to use the Lucky Tiger treatment.
Lucky Tiger?
Yes, indeedy. Now, if you'll just step through this door here.
Lucky Tiger.
I hate to say this, but isn't that a little dangerous?
That's right. Nurse, that man may be killed. Oh, what have I done? I gotta run out and get some help. I gotta hurry. But first, just one thing.
What's that, Dr. Darling?
Yes, Nick.
Please, doctor, here's your next patient.
Doctor.
Yes.
Doctor, my goodness. Why, you're looking manlier and huskier than you have ever looked before.
Wait a minute, that's my nurse. This is me behind the umbrella stand.
Oh, behind the umbrella style?
Yes.
Oh, for goodness sakes. Well, how do you look when you're open? No, doctor, can you help me, Dr. Fram? My life has been miserable since you treated me.
How so?
Well, people used to point at me and... well, they didn't exactly. Yes, they did, too. And they'd whisper, there goes Ursula Twing. And they'd say, he's only half saved.
I see. And now?
Well, they say I'm utterly dangerous.
Well, is that all?
Well, it sounded like it was, yes.
Yes.
Well, all I mean is, a few months ago, my best friends wouldn't tell me. No, they wouldn't. They wouldn't just tell me at all. But now...
Yes, now...
Everybody does. They blab it right back in my face, and I spend all my money on Kleenex.
Well, of course, that's nothing to sneeze at. It's a very... That's a very...
Just read what's written on the paper.
This is a very baffling case. Yes, tell me, Ursula, have you tried Life Boy?
Do you think we ought to set the scene all over again?
Yes.
Life Boy? Well, for goodness sake, I certainly have. I've never without a cake under each little arm.
Isn't that a pity? It's own pity, yes. Well, let's see what we can do for you, nurse.
Ready, doctor, honey.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Sponge.
Sponge.
Soap. Drano. Steel wool.
Steel wool.
Bathtub. And now, nurse, if you'll excuse us a moment.
Oh, all right.
And now, Stinky, take off your clothes.
Dr. Kaiser, if you lay one finger on me, I'll bite it off. And not only that, I'll fly into a big tizzy. And I'll pound my fist on your puny little chest. And I'll reach way down and swing from the floor, and I'll just give you a big pinch.
Congratulations, Mr. Twing. I see that with the gentle Lux care, you keep your dainty intimate things fresh up to three times as long. And now first, we'll use the Dreen on you.
The Dreen on me?
Yes, that's the gloriously new different Dreen. A miracle shampoo adored by shining Hollywood stars like Merle Oberon.
Oh, goody, goody, big fat gumdrop.
And now I'll pour cologne on you. One bucket is enough.
Oh, it's cold.
And a teensy touch of fragrant bath salts. Oh, about 4 pounds.
Oh, not so hard.
And perfume. Listerine.
Yeah.
Toilet water.
Yeah.
Simpson.
Oh.
Oh, Mr. Twing. Oh, now. Oh, you smell. You're just like a garden of roses.
Oh, God.
Oh, doctor, honey, darling, Lanny Pie.
Yes, nurse.
Are you ready to make love to me now?
Oh.
Oh, but wait. I have something to say to Mr. Twing.
You have, friend? What is this?
Yes, Nick.
Oh, stop.